good morning, good afternoon, and good evening, ladies, gentlemen, and everyone else watching. Welcome to the much-awaited Vaxei versus maliszewski show match. The tournament GOAT Vaxei, undefeated for several years now in any tournament match whatsoever, versus the new kid on the block, maliszewski, in a sense, Bubble Man's replacement, someone who has played almost any and every tournament around, looking to build the tournament consistency and reputation of someone who is undefeatable in tournaments, looking to open up a spot on Vaxei's current throne. My name is Dio, and I'm here to cast this match alongside Miles. Good afternoon, Miles. A very good afternoon.
Yeah, it's a great afternoon. We're watching Vaxei versus maliszewski. If you were to compare this to something like real-life sports, this might just be something like LeBron James versus Michael Jordan, Lionel Messi versus Cristiano Ronaldo, Roger Federer versus Novak Djokovic. These are pretty much the two best players we've had basically in the last decade, both very, very dominant in their own times. Obviously, Vaxei hasn't really played much in this era. I think his last major 1v1 tournament was Yuki Aim tournament in 2021,
yep,
which he did win undefeated, of course. But since then, it's really been the maliszewski show, so I guess this is kind of going to be seeing if Vaxei can turn back time here.
Yeah, and I think for a lot of people, this is going to be really interesting in terms of, you know, maliszewski did just lose last weekend in Courses Closed to MREC, but Vaxei is a very different opponent, and this is a very different pool. So I'm really interested in seeing whether a spot on the throne opens up. I'm not necessarily going to say that winning this makes maliszewski the new GOAT, because the undefeatable record that Vaxei has is very different from maliszewski's own run through the tournament scene. But certainly, if he is able to take down Vaxei here, I think it's going to be a step in that direction, that's for sure.
Yeah, and obviously Vaxei just played in a completely different era back then. He played against some of the other all-time greats, such as Wubbles Wolf and Bubble Man. But it was really a different era when it came to skill cap and map pools. This map pool that we're seeing right here is much more difficult than anything that Vaxei has ever played in a badged tournament. And although I think he might be going, honestly, for a similar strategy as MREC here against maliszewski, going to be picking the harder stuff. This is kind of, I guess, unseen territory even for Vaxei.
We have seen, apparently, Vaxei just played and FC'd Yomiuri, by the way.
Which one?
I think the one, right?
What?
Or is it a different one?
The Jokito one?
Farm one. Okay. Good. All right.
Good
to see. I was like, wait a second. I'm here casting. I'm looking at chat. I'm seeing words in chat. That's all I have to go off of. Thank God it's not the Dokido one. That'd be a little crap. Anyway, yeah. To draw off your point, Miles. The last two badges that Vaxei had were Yuki Aim and the perennial 2021. One of the maps in Hard Rock right now, Angel Salad, was a custom map for grand finals of the perennial 2021 in No Mod. That was the custom map, No Mod 6. So this is, it's a much harder pool. It's a much harder map pool. That said, the pool in Yuki Aim, I think, is definitely around the same difficulty as this one, actually, or at least approaching it. So there's certainly a lot of... speculation around whether Vaxei can compete on the higher star rating pools. We already saw maliszewski be able to put up really, really high scores on the Courses Closed pool last weekend, so not as much speculation. We know this guy's good up to like 8.5 stars or so.
But yeah, for Vaxei, it was always like, I feel like we always knew he would be able to play a map pool of this caliber, but he just wasn't really active in the time where we really saw it. I mean, Courses Closed, I think, this year, pushing boundaries to what's acceptable in a map pool. We finally found the long-awaited skill cap of maliszewski. MREC did abuse the skill cap against maliszewski, but still, I think this pool is still going to be in maliszewski's wheelhouse, and the big question mark is really just Vaxei in this match.
Yeah, Well, if recent streams and recent scores set by Vaxei are any indicator, I think he's going to be relatively solid anyway on a map pool like this.
Yeah.
Like you said, I think it was just a matter of the times. He just really didn't play in a time where map pools this difficult were acceptable in the tournament scene, where if you found a map pool of this difficulty, A, the maps just kind of didn't exist, right? And B, the players were not really there. They just weren't quite as strong as they are today on any map pool, pretty much. So I think a lot of this is going to come down to Vaxei being able to apply the skill cap and consistency he had from years past to a pool of this caliber. Also, we'll take a closer look at this when we get to the map pool, but I think some of the map pool composition might end up favoring one player or another, because there are skill sets that Vaxei was weaker on or stronger on depending on the sort of map. Even though he was usually one of the best players on a map, he wasn't always the best player on a given map during tournaments with teams.
Yeah, if you remember way back when, it was Bubble Man and Wubbuff Wolf who really abused gimmick into Vaxei. Although the maps back then were not nearly as gimmicky as the maps today, it was still something that it wasn't necessarily a super reliable win, because Vaxei did, you know, go completely undefeated. But it was something that a player like Bubble Man or Wubbuff Wolf could win at least like 2/3 of the time. And I think on a map pool like this that really pushes gimmick to the extreme on some of the maps like that Gnome on 6 or that Hidden 2, probably going to be things that maliszewski will look into, maybe could be a ban from Vaxei. But then on the other end, we saw it last week, I think Vaxei is going to go into, I think, the high end mechanics up against maliszewski. Things like the DT1, the Gnome on 5, speed in general, probably going to go his way. But I think aim is going to be a really, really tough matchup to call against these two players. And I'm really going to be, I guess, curious to see who decides to pick some aim. Also, look at these scores on this warm-up, by the way. This map is almost 8 stars as well. Both of them,
they're looking pretty good. They're looking pretty good. I have to say, they definitely look solid on this map. Very, very close. I hope this is how the rest of the match goes. If every map is as close as that warm-up, then I'm really looking forward to the rest of the match.
Yeah, same. I mean, Vaxei, it was such a question mark. When he came back a few weeks ago, maybe a month ago, I don't think anyone really expected it, or at least expected him to look as good as he was. It was almost as if he never left when he booted up that stream. He was playing just the same maps he was back then. He was not rusty whatsoever. And now we're going to get another really difficult map in this warm-up. 9.59 stars on this one.
I always love 9.5-star AM maps like this one. Always really good. I think my tournament client did not download the map, however. So, that's cool. You know, love when that happens. We'll see if it works. Hopefully it does. I don't think it is, though. So I'm gonna wait for them to start the map, and then I'll download it real quick as we get into it. In the meantime, I'm also gonna go ahead and... It's definitely not downloading. Now I've got Candyland on, apparently, according to the tournament client. This is definitely not Candyland, though. Oh, there we go. Okay, it changed the map. Perfect. That's what I'm talking
awesome.
About.
Awesome. This is a classic.
That's just a
Candyland?
Classic. Candyland.
I remember when this was the most, or it was considered like super overmapped and way too difficult for the song, but now it's only 7.27 stars, but still, the tech maps in this map pool are much more difficult than this.
This guy, man, he had to. Oh my god. Well, yeah, I mean, this is really not as hard as the tech maps in the pool, though, like you said. It's really not actually all that difficult, so I'm interested whether they're just going for FCs on this or what. Although, that said, this map's pretty hard anyway.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, it was only a few years ago where you might see this type of map in a grand final scenario, but I think a lot of poolers just ended up avoiding this map because of, I think, the reputation this map built up back in, say, I think it was like 2017 or 2018 this map showed up. And it was really either you love it or you hate it, and I think the map pooling people just didn't really like it. But still, what if they double FC this? I think they're both very much good enough to do so. If If they're starting.
Hopefully we get into it shortly here, as just a little bit of a delay getting into the warm-ups. Maliszewski back after helping his parents with something. Yeah, I'm just really interested to see exactly how this match breaks down. Gonna go ahead and pull up the map pool and talk a little bit about, like, what we expect from the picks for both of these players. Because I feel like once they get going, it's gonna be relatively fast. It is a 1v1 after all. So let's talk about that a little bit, shall we? I feel like you're going to see bans on reading and or alt from Vaxei, and probably bans on hard rock from Maliszewski. Thoughts?
I think that's pretty accurate. You know, we could see bans on speed from Maliszewski as well, but I really don't know how Vaxei will fend on this high speed, things like Just Awake DT, Kimi no Kyoku. I think Maliszewski has an FC on that, doesn't he?
Maliszewski does have an FC on Kimi no Kyoku, yeah.
Okay, so he's not going to be very afraid of that map. But I think what Vaxei will want to pick, though, is probably some of the Nomad speedier maps. Something like that Nomad 2 or the Nomad 5. Probably going to be picks for Vaxei, maybe bans for Maliszewski. But I'm pretty sure you're accurate in your analysis on the rest. Probably Hard Rock bans for Maliszewski. Yep. Maybe something like that HR 4 or 3. I think 1 and 2 probably stay open. Hard Rock 2 maybe just might as well be a Maliszewski pick. Ryoshi no Umi no Lindworm, that is alt aim control.
Yeah, that one definitely staying open. Again, Vaxei not particularly an alt player. Usually very, very good on Hard Rock, but that Hard Rock 2 not particularly in his favor. I think on something like Angel Salad, he's going to be much better off. But the Hard Rock 3 as well is 146 BPM. You've got two alt maps in this Hard Rock pool. I think very, very good for Maliszewski in a matchup like this. That said, the hidden pool, a little less ulti. There's only one of them in that pool. So you might actually see Vaxei go into the hidden pool a little bit when it doesn't come to the reading maps. I think that low AR hidden probably banned out against Maliszewski. And Vaxei potentially going into the rest of the pool with, like you said, speed, mechanics, and probably some like DT tech. I don't know who this DT4 favors, because both of these players are really good at that skill set.
I couldn't tell you either, but one thing I'd like to point out is the HD2 isn't necessarily all too hard of a reading map, so to say. It's AR8, but I think it's really mostly going to be focused on that grid snap aim, dazzle hop. Something that Vaxei, like, back in the day, Vaxei was a very competent reading player, even though it was often picked into him. If his opponent wasn't necessarily ready, it was something that Vaxei was able to strike on and take some breakpoints off of. So I think probably Nomad 6 will be a lot more scary for Vaxei than something like the Hidden 2. But the rest of the Hidden pool probably could be a toss-up, but you probably favor Maliszewski just on the virtue of, you know, it's Maliszewski. That guy's the hidden player of all time, I guess.
Yeah, that definitely will help. I'm very ready for him to show us what he's got on some of the hidden picks, as I'm very glad we had warm-ups, because Maliszewski's ping does not show combo, by the way. What is Vaxei doing? He is still going. I think that's an FC, yeah? I'm pretty sure.
Yeah, Vaxei, by the way. If any of you forgot who he was or didn't know who he was before he came back, this is why he was considered the best of all time. Because he can do stuff like this. No way, right? He's just gonna...
Way, actually.
Way. He's gonna FC Candyland in a warm-up. That is something that does happen. Oh, wow.
Wow, okay. Yeah, that's a Candyland FC in warm-up. Yeah, like you said, you know, this guy's pretty good, actually. He's,
okay, at the game, at least.
Pretty alright at the game, yeah, gotta say. You know, still got it. Still got it after all this time. Got it after a while. Suddenly my tournament client has disappeared from my screen. Luckily, it's still on everybody else's. And hopefully, I think I have fixed Maliszewski's skin so that we get a combo counter in the bottom right. And now, it's time for bans. It's time for bans, Miles. See if we're right about exactly what is going on in this pool. As a reminder for everyone, this pool is like above 8.5 stars generally on the mechanics picks and averages over 8 stars. So this is a really, really difficult map pool. You have stuff like Angel Salad, Hard Rock, Just Awake DT, Kimi no Kyoka DT, Piranha DT is DT1. That's cool. The Nomad maps are mostly unranked because people don't rank maps that hard for the most part. We'll see exactly where they want to go.
Vaxei gonna be winning the roll, so he's gonna have the choice of pick order or ban order. Okay, my personal opinion is you usually go second pick in a matchup that you think could be close, but we're gonna see what Vaxei goes for.
I think second ban here is also probably fine, but less impactful, because I think the bans are mostly clear-cut for these two players if they've done their research about each other, if they understand the matchup pretty well. And yeah, Vaxei going for second pick, like you said, taking the clincher, as it were. If you have a breakpoint up, you get last pick and you can close out. If you are down a point and it's otherwise even going into a tiebreaker, you have last pick and can close out that way, guarantee yourself a tiebreaker. So usually pretty good to have that second pick, and it kind of helps with nerves as well. You gotta imagine both of these players are at least a little nervous going into each other, right? Vaxei versus maliszewski. This is Vaxei coming back for one more match after having pretty much retired. Man has not played a tournament since Yuki Aim 2021, and the last matchup he played was against Emrek, where it went to tiebreaker, where he won tiebreaker by 20,000 points. So this is a Vaxei that, while still undefeated over the last several years, hasn't been playing tournaments, just recently came back against a maliszewski who is in practice, in form, but just lost last weekend to Emrek as well. So I'm really, really interested to see exactly how this matchup goes, whether they're nervous at all, or whether we see pretty much them just playing out of their minds. Early Hidden 2, Hidden 3 bans from Vaxei, and DT1, DT3 bans from maliszewski. Not super surprising for now maliszewski to go into his first pick. Again, banning out high approach rate DT and DT speed against Vaxei, always pretty good. Banning out low approach rate reading and hidden tech from Vaxei, I think, is actually a little interesting in banning out Fever Dream.
Yeah, and there's still a Nomad 6 open. You have AR6 stack reading, something that maliszewski basically has free reign over the entire tourney community over these days. So I could assume that the Nomad 6 is probably going to be an early pick for maliszewski. But yeah, as you said, ban's pretty expected, but however, all hard rocks remained open. maliszewski saying, well, I guess I just go with bangers. Hidden 1 gonna be the first pick for maliszewski, choosing not to abuse the obvious reading pick. Gonna go for the 240 BPM hidden aim pick instead. And this could be a bit of a toss-up, I think.
Definitely could be. Definitely could be a little bit of a toss-up. This map is really hard. This is 8.6 stars. 40 BPM, awkward aim, very bursty at times, but generally just very, very high skill cap aim on this map. And here we go into the first map of the matchup. Miles, maliszewski's pick, who do you have your sights on during this map? I think it's probably still a maliszewski win on this map, but like you said, this is way more of a toss-up than you really expect from a first pick most of the time.
Yeah, I mean, maliszewski, if you look at any leaderboard on a map like this, it's gonna be a maliszewski number one. This is, I think, as much as I said it's a toss-up pick, it's only that way because it's something that Vaxei can pretty much play fairly comfortably. See, maliszewski still holding onto the SS, but Vaxei up at 99.6 out of the beginning. But yeah, this is just maliszewski's wheelhouse. The hidden aim, the fast aim. Although there are some long bursts, it's nothing that he can't handle. I think this is probably going to be a maliszewski pick. But if Vaxei holds on, it could be something he steals, but he does not. And maliszewski's going to take an early lead now. About 360 combo in the bank. Vaxei is missing a lot, and it looks already like a pick that could be dominated. Oh, but there goes the first break for maliszewski.
This is kind of what we were talking about, in that there are definitely maps where Vaxei is not the best player in the game. And I think this is probably one of them. he finds another miss. Maliszewski had broken a couple times before that as well. This is still close. It's only 25k apart. Neither player with a decisive lead right now. It's a bit of an ACK lead, a bit of a combo lead, a bit of a score lead for Maliszewski, but nothing crazy. And like we were saying, a bit of a toss-up map, but something that Maliszewski still favored on, hoping to find the win on this one as we get into the second half. A bit more of the slow section first, though.
And you know, these slow sections are really dangerous on a map like this that has some very definitive difficult sections, because if Maliszewski finds a break earlier on into the next hard part, Vaxei will be able to claw back a lead. But Vaxei is going to be finding the first break into the next difficult section, so Maliszewski is going to be able to extend his lead even more, especially with that accuracy lead as well. He's going to look to start running away with this lead now, blossoming up to around 70,000. So in the last third of the map, we're really going to need a miracle for Vaxei to take this one.
I want to see what kind of combo Maliszewski can put up on this. Looking very, very good on this map so far. I'm really interested to see exactly what kind of a combo he can put up in the back half here. Hit one of the hard parts, hit the awkward below AM 1/3 section as well. Let's see it. He's already above 400k. The point's in the bag at this point, right? So nothing more to talk about in terms of whether he wins the map or not. Just can you combo this last TI time, the last quarter of the map? So, so difficult, even in comparison to a lot of the other sections in this map. If he actually combos through this, he's a demon. Like, actually, this part is so difficult. Can he do it? He's still holding, hits the slider jumps. Oh, finally finds some slider breaks on the slider jump. Hollow Wings. Hollow Wings 3-point jump, sir. I forget the map they're from. Sentimental Skyscraper. Finally drops. 200k, though, at the end. Really, really solid score from Maliszewski and the troll break here at the end. Love the mapper for this one.
Mm-hmm. 8.6 stars is this map. Maliszewski, 548k. Going to be winning that one by about 200,000, a little bit more than that. Still, as we said, very definitive of a first pick for Maliszewski, although it looked a little bit dicey in some of the earlier sections. It was definitely a strong pick for him, so gonna see how Vaxei responds here. He still's got that Nomad 2 open, as well as the Nomad 5. I think he might decide to go into some of the difficult aim as well, but we're gonna have to see.
Well, definitely liked seeing that one. Good hit in one pick from Maliszewski, 200k up over Vaxei on the first pick, up 1-0 to start off. And now into Vaxei's first pick. I feel like after the double DT bans from Maliszewski, if you are picking normally, you probably go for something like the DT2 or Nomad 5. You know, pick some more high approach rate stuff or pick some more speed stuff. That said, he might not pick normally. He might go for just whatever feels good. Nomad 2, Nomad 4, potentially. After full comboing Candyland to start off in the warmups, I'm not super surprised. And apparently this map got an update since I downloaded the map pack. Yes, last updated 5 days ago. Thank you very much. Okay, well, be right back with tournament client. Hold on.
Yeah, love the tourney client.
But
typically, like, into Maliszewski, you never really want to pick tech. Like, it's one of Maliszewski's strongest skill sets. But as you said, Vaxei, if you have C Candyland in the warm-up of the match, you might as well just be confident on this tech pick. Maybe get one of the more risky picks out of the way first. Because, you know, it's a best of 13, right? First to seven?
It is.
Yeah,
best
you've got
of
a lot of maps. Lots of maps to choose from. Lots of maps to be played. Might as well get a risky one out of the way first. Nomad 4.
Yes, map, not a typical Nomad 4 either. This is 220 BPM, 8.5 stars, AR 9.8, OD 10. So you've got actually quite a lot of, like, different, you've got quite a different sort of map. There's a lot of speed in this map that there isn't usually in a lot of other maps. And sorry for a very loud tournament client for a second there. There we go. Ready to go with the next map, this Nomad 4. Again, 220 BPM. There's actually a lot of streams in this map. If I remember right from the showcase, this is a lot of tech stream sections into a really, really difficult slider aim section near the end of the map into yet more high BPM tech stream. So I'm looking to see who can combo the slider aim section in the middle, or if it ends up mattering at all, because, again, there is a lot of those really high BPM tech stream sections, and you know, if maliszewski is feeling like his stamina isn't particularly good right now, then it might end up just being Vaxei's win off of the fact that this is a very streamy Nomad 4.
Yeah, and you know, Vaxei in solo is very keen to play some of this high BPM tech, mechanics tech, so to speak. Something that he's very good at in solo, as you're probably very familiar with, but both players are going to be finding drops right out of the start, and as well as some accuracy drops as well. Wow, both players go down. Vaxei goes down even further, down to 92% out of the beginning. Maliszewski holding on up at 97, but we've still got a lot of map to go, so we're going to see if Vaxei can find his footing. Here into the tech stream section, as you mentioned, already so brutal. Maliszewski finding some drops. Vaxei is going to look to take the lead here if he can hold on to some more combo. And Vaxei's holding on. Vaxei's holding on. He is still holding on. He's comboed most of this tech stream section, finally finding the break. But the lead is still in favor of Maliszewski because of his super strong accuracy. Look at him all the way almost up at 98. Such a strong performance despite the combo drop. He has found his combo back up at 350. He combos through the ending of that difficult section, and he's going to look to take a 20k lead on Vaxei's first pick.
See if Maliszewski can hold through the slider in section. He does not hold through the stream. Oh no, that was a Bancho miss. Does hold through them. Bancho really doesn't like tech maps sometimes, especially really high snap divisor sliders like we saw in those streams. Here we go into the slider aim section, though. This might just decide the map. If Maliszewski can hold here and Vaxei misses, it may as well be over. But Maliszewski is the first one to find a slider break instead. Vaxei able to hold through this part. Does he hold through the entire section is the question. The score lead should start to swap over soon, but it's still about 20k right now. Vaxei looking to take the lead back once again on this Nomad 4 pick. Hitting the Sliderator sliders as well. The sliders that slow down in the middle of them. Definitely some new gen tech in there, but Vaxei still holding on. No tournament wins since 2021. No problem for someone who never rusts. This guy just holds through one of the most difficult sections in the map. Held before then through a lot of the streams as well. And is looking to secure the point with the next tech stream section. Hits the whole infinity sign stream there. Doesn't even drop ACK on that part of the map. And can he hold through the ending is the question now. This part is so, so difficult. The spacing, the wiggles, everything in this part so tricky. Vaxei missing the stream, and Maliszewski does have combo right now, but there's only so much map left. Can he hold on long enough to take the point? No, he cannot. It's gonna go to Vaxei. The combo during the slider aim section, too much for anyone to combat.
Yeah, despite the large accuracy deficit for Vaxei in the middle section of the map, that big combo he was able to hold is gonna balloon him up to a victory on this Nomad 4. I personally questioned this first pick, but you know, it worked out in the end. Vaxei proving why he decided to go with it. Nomad 4, high BPM tech is his, gonna be winning that one. Gonna be evening up the score now, one apiece. He got 1100 combo on that. That is completely unreal, out comboing Maliszewski. Even with the accuracy lead, Maliszewski whole percent ahead. And you know, on a pool this hard, accuracy matters a lot more than I think a lot of people think, but Vaxei making use of the combo finally. So gonna see how Maliszewski responds to this. I think this is something that a lot of people didn't really expect to go the way of Vaxei, but he's just proving why he's the GOAT.
Yeah, I mean, you see the full combo on Candyland right before the match starts. Can't help but think maybe the tech map is contested at the very least.
Yeah, just
but,
maybe.
You know, Vaxei, again, still one of the best tech players in the game. It's not as if he ever really stopped being good at tech either. He just hasn't shown up in a long time, hasn't played the game in a long time. But that's not going to stop him from taking this point, and it's not going to stop Maliszewski from continuing his own pick strategy going into the alt pick in Hidden. This is not really normal alt, though. This is essentially an Aquaro map, but in Hidden. There's the low AR reading, you know, easy player Aquaro map, and then there's the new gen devious panda finger control Ikoro map, and that is what we have here. Both of these players well-versed in this style of mapping. 2021, when Vaxei made his last run of a couple big tournaments, was when those maps were really starting to get introduced in their whole. They were around in both OWC 2020 and in a couple tournaments before that as well, so it's not going to be something he's super unfamiliar with at all in tournament. Maliszewski, though, kind of grew up in the age of Ikoro Devious Panda finger control maps in tournament, and with Hidden On, this is right up his alley. This is exactly the kind of map that he wants to see in the Hidden Pool. Look at the accuracy already. 99% to 95, 96. Finally, a drop comes through for Maliszewski, though. Vaxei now. Miles, you were talking about combo game on the last map. Never mind. Why speak?
It's over. Yep. Finding the break, Vaxei now at a huge disadvantage. A lot of it down to the accuracy, but some of the drops Maliszewski had really tanking his accuracy down to mid-96. But when compared to Vaxei's low 94, it's not really going to be too much. And I think Maliszewski, as long as he's able to hold on to a little combo, should be looking to run into the ending with this one. Still half of the map to go, but I think it's going to already take a miracle. As Vaxei, down at 100 combo, Maliszewski breaking his 330 combo. Hold on a second, he drops a lot of accuracy too. We might have a map on our hands. Vaxei holding on to the combo, as well as the accuracy, surpassing Maliszewski. And the lead has also gone way down, back down to 20k, but Vaxei finds the drop. Maliszewski now going to look to start running away with the lead once again as the accuracy goes back in his favor and the lead balloons up to 40,000, but I think the ending is really going to determine this. Who can hit it better?
Yeah, this map is evil. Tons of different beat snap divisors in this, and the accuracy, like you said, playing a major role now, finally, with Maliszewski dropping the accuracy down. You can see exactly how much the combo is going to matter here. 100 combo up for Maliszewski going into the ending. Does drop on one of the aim control patterns. One of those one-third triples is what might give Vaxei the win on this map. Maliszewski drops on one of them. Vaxei finally drops as well in turn. And it's a 40k score lead, but that's going to be enough for Maliszewski to take this pick up 2-1. The picks going the way you expect them to so far. Each player just winning their own picks for the first three maps. 2-1 in Maliszewski's favor, Vaxei with the next pick. And you can see by the end of the map, both of those players really struggling in the accuracy department. 93% for both players. Really expected on a map like that, where you have not only 1/3, 1/4, 1/6, but also some 1/5 and 1/7 in the editor, if you take a look. So, yeah, very, very difficult to act something like that. Also, a couple of, I think those were 1/12th doubles earlier on in the map. Very, very tricky stuff to act, and honestly, really incredible that Maliszewski held such good act for such a long time on that map anyway.
Mm-hmm. But I do think that that was closer than a lot of us anticipated, so maybe Maliszewski could have a little bit of cold feet going into a pick like Hard Rock 4, Angel Salad. Something that I think on paper could be a little bit favored towards Maliszewski, but after Hidden 4 being that close, although it's a completely different ballpark when you're playing that type of map with Hard Rock, could be something that Maliszewski could be a little bit wary to pick in the future. But now Vaxei going to go for his own comfort pick as well, going to go for that Nomad 5, 239 BPM speed stamina, mapped by Taquito, up at 8.34 stars, and I feel like this should just be a map that is very favored to Vaxei.
Shoutouts to Taquito, by the way. This is a custom map for the show match. Definitely something I'm feeling is favored towards Vaxei. That said, it's only 239 BPM. Take that with a grain of salt. Maliszewski really struggles a lot more with the higher BPM speed stamina. That's why you see the ban out on double time 3, for example. But on a map like this, it might be doable for him to take a break point. That said, he said his stamina was not feeling as good as it usually does going into this match. Much. I think this comes down to whether his stamina has recovered or not, and I don't think it has.
Nope.
Drops a lot of combo, a lot of accuracy, down to 92% ACK for Maliszewski now going into the finger control section here. And this map never really stops. You get the long stream section into finger control and first spam into more long streams into some almost tech stream shapes at 240 BPM. These wiggle streams are really what makes this map so difficult to combo through. At this point, it's not a question of whether Vaxei will win, only how high the score will go.
Wait a minute.
Maybe. Actually, he has completely dropped all stamina, it looks
oh,
like.
Oh, no.
Not able to hit any of the streams. I spoke too soon. as maliszewski now actually has a little bit of an ACK advantage, not by much, but by a little bit. And it might just come down to how well they do in the second half here. That said, maliszewski not able to hold the combo, Vaxei not able to hold the combo. Can anyone put up a decisive combo in this map? It looks like it's actually maliszewski able to hold on better, able to not drop score, not drop combo, and not drop accuracy. And it's the score lead shrinking toward maliszewski now in the back half of this map, back into the first spam section, as both players able to finally hold on during this part. Is that enough for maliszewski to take it? He has combo lead and act lead by 3% going into the ending here, Miles. It might just be enough. The score lead shrinking down to less than 20,000 as maliszewski continues to hold. He hits the wiggle stream.
Oh my god, they both find drops, but I think Vaxei's combo in the beginning just might be enough to edge it out over maliszewski's accuracy lead. It is almost 4%. But Vaxei's early combo, wait a minute, he finds another drop in the ending. Maliszewski has a combo, 100 combo lead.
Spin to win!
Final spinner, it's a spin to win! Vaxei gonna
oh
take it!
Oh my god, it's
500
it's,
points! What?
It's 546 points, the margin of victory for Vaxei. Combo game, once again, comes out on top by the absolute slimmest of margins. And it
oh
looks
my
like
God.
It looks like the tournament client was actually incorrect, by the way, if you look at the MP link, but it is still a Vaxei win by 1146. 1146 points is the margin of victory for Vaxei. Incredibly close still. But somebody fix this tournament client, by God.
Please. But yeah, I was gonna say you can't get closer than that. But in Vaxei's times, he has lost closer than that against Poland and the UK in OWC, if anyone remembers those matches. Those were crazy. But still, in a 1v1 setting, that is about as close as you can get. 1,000 score, that could literally be one or two circles, one accuracy drop, one anything could have shifted it over. But Vaxei's combo was enough. Gonna be evening it up 2-2. Now, okay, maliszewski tries to pick it in 3, but it was banned out by Vaxei. Gonna see what he decides to actually pick. The hidden pool is completely gone. Still has that Nomad 6 available to him. I assume he's just going to go for that at some point.
Nomad 3, actually.
Oh, this map is insane. Oh,
this map Parody's is...
Inferno.
This map goes crazy. Go ahead and talk about it.
Okay, so pretty much what you need to know is that this is the nerfed diff. The top diff's diff name is Crackheadium Mortis. So, yeah, it pretty much embodies that. It's a Jonesen map, also known as Evil Elvis, also known as Nutbeck Des, but it's basically the epitome, the crown, the king of awkward aim alt. It is the most awkward aim control focused alt map I have pretty much ever seen, but it also has some very difficult slider streams as well, but it might actually be gone in the nerf diff. I actually haven't compared the two difficulties, but gonna see how they do it on this. I think this is something that Vaxei can certainly play, but alt has just been a maliszewski skill set in the last year. But Vaxei is gonna be finding an early drop on one of those slider doubles. Gonna be dropping on that kick slider. Maliszewski still holding on to his 99.5 FC through these beginning patterns. Finding the drop though, but the accuracy lead for maliszewski is gonna give him an early lead of around 10,000. But there's still a lot of map to go. Still 3 minutes or so of alt map to go. Gonna see if Vaxei can bring this back with some more combo, because as we've seen so far this match, maliszewski's really been ahead in the accuracy department.
He definitely has. I think one thing though for this map is I really don't expect Vaxei to be... I think this is like less of a toss-up pick than the hidden one, for example. Vaxei has historically struggled a lot with alt picks at both the highest level and even at lower levels. I remember back in Yuki Aim in 2021, he even lost alt picks in like round of 32, in matchups where, you know, you really don't expect him to be losing maps at all. So this skill set is something that he has struggled with for quite a while. That said, he's keeping it real close right now, holding on to combo where maliszewski broke a little bit later on in the map and now might just be able to take this point. Again, not to say he's bad at the skill set, but it's definitely something you don't see him picking against a lot of players, at least recently. Go back to the Perennial and Yuki Aim, the two most recent wins for him, and oh my god, what did he just hit,
okay.
Though? Okay. He broke on the second one, thank god. I was like, no, you can't do me like this after I talk about this. You can't hit both of those after I just talked about that. That said, it's still very close right now. I think if he finds the pop-off in the second half, he could still win this. Maliszewski ahead on accuracy, ahead in combo right now. But Vaxei cannot be counted out of this map because some of the patterns in this are, well, you know, Trachedius Morbum.
Yep, Trachedius Mortis. Yeah, as you were talking about, I would like to reference, I think it was OWC 2019 when the United States lost like one of their 3 points of that tournament to Turkey on the round of 32 alt pick. So definitely not something that Vaxei is feeling the best on, and Maliszewski has brought that lead up now to around 80,000, up with a 400 combo and a 3% ACK lead. He's going to be running this one into the ending and taking his third pick. Pretty sure there's nothing Vaxei can do at this point.
Yeah, no. Definitely count him out now, because Maliszewski decided to pop off. He finally finds a miss here in the last ki or so on some just absolutely absurd linear spacing. But yeah, Vaxei kept it close for quite a time until it really just wasn't close at all. Those patterns, by the way, I don't know how both of them hit that. That was kind of crazy. Very, very good pick for Maliszewski. Very, very good pick for Maliszewski, and I think should give him a lot of confidence going into any and all of the other alt maps.
Of which there are not too many remaining, though. The hidden pool is completely gone. Vaxei banning out the alt map in that pool. I would say there's still, I guess, an alt map in, if you count DT4, which is tech, as also alt. I'm not really sure if it exactly is, but could be something you might look into. But I think when it comes to pure alt picks, there really isn't much left in this pool. Vaxei doing a good job banning some of that out, but Maliszewski going to be taking that pick definitively by the end of it. And we're going to see how Vaxei responds now. I think out of some of the most comfortable picks for him, he still has, I think, a Nomad 2 and a DT2 remaining, which really do, I think, on paper favor him. But obviously, Maliszewski, being who he is, you can't really guarantee any pick against a player like him.
No, definitely not.
Vaxei. And also, there was a curse, I think, a lot of people remember during early in Course Ace Close, as well as the Roundtable Qualifier Tournament, where people would win 2 points against Maliszewski, but then not win any more. Well, you look, Vaxei's got 2 points, so obviously if that curse is still holding true, Maliszewski could just sweep it from here.
I don't think it's still holding. Bro lost to MREC last weekend. Let's not forget.
It's true. I don't forget.
I don't think the curse is still there. Definitely during Roundtable Qualifiers it was there, but that was a very different tournament from something like Course Ace Closed or like this show match. So I'm looking forward to seeing a much closer match between these two players.
God, I hope.
I hope. I really want, I think, Nomad 2 here from Vaxei is a really, really good pick. Maliszewski's stamina, he has been complaining about it. Probably just want to abuse that a little bit if you are going for the best pick possible. Hard Rock 2, though, gonna be the pick from Vaxei instead. Okay, I'm interested in this one. I don't know if does he have a score on this? Does he already have a score on this? Is that why he's picking this?
I'm not sure, but this could just be... I was calling Nomad 4 risky, but this is really risky. If Vaxei wins this, then I think I can just throw everything I thought about him as a player out the window because, you know, this might just be like, you know, Maliszewski won the last alt pick. This is probably the closest thing we have to an alt pick left in this pool, as well as some very difficult aim control as well and finger control. But, you know, if Vaxei picks it, Vaxei picks it. That's something that I guess we just have to accept.
Yeah, he does have a Nomad S rank on this map from 3 years ago, but I don't know how much I trust Nomad when this is on Hard Rock. Map is absolutely demon on Hard Rock, that's for sure.
Yeah, there is... I don't even know if there's a Hard Rock FC on this. I haven't looked at the leaderboard. There is not. Okay, so that's pretty much all you need to know about this. This map is very iconic, been used in a lot of big tournaments throughout the years, I think most notably OWC 2017, where I think it was a lower difficulty, was won by Poland in order to win the match, but still, this map has been along for a very long time, and I'm sure many players have attempted it with Hard Rock. But, you know, right now, Vaxei has kind of a massive, very small lead. He finally drops his combo, so it's going to go back in favor of Maliszewski for now. Once again, I think, mostly off of the accuracy, all the way up at 98 for Maliszewski, even though Vaxei, about even in the combo, it's not really going to go anywhere if that accuracy lead is that big. But Maliszewski does finally find a drop from the 200-ish combo he amassed, so the lead is going to be just around 30k in his favor. There's only a third-ish of the map to go, so Vaxei does have time, but he needs to hold through one of the very difficult sections, like the ending part. but I don't know if you can do that. That map, or that part of the map, is so difficult.
Yeah, this accuracy lead for maliszewski just doing so much work, and consistent breaks for Vaxei during the middle part might be the determining factor here, although he holds through that 280 BPM burst. He finally finds a drop. Maliszewski now, it's on him not to chain miss, not to break a ton and drop the score a bunch during the ending here. He does find a couple of misses. They're matched by Vaxei. It's 20k. The score lead for maliszewski right now. Accuracy lead closed in by Vaxei now. Score lead very, very small, still around that 20k mark. Any chain misses from either player at the end here could swing it entirely, but neither of them will miss, and it's going to be our first break point of the match. Over to maliszewski, 4-2, up against Vaxei now. As, like you said, Miles, I feel like it's a bit of a mispick from Vaxei to pick something like Ryoshino Umino Lindworm into maliszewski. We've talked about how Vaxei, not the best alt player in the world. Maliszewski, one of the best alt players in the world. Yes, it's a hard rock map. Yes, it's a high circle size map. This is, I believe, CS 6.98 or something like that. 6.9 circle size. But not enough when the map's skill set is so favored toward maliszewski on that one. And now you definitely, I think, favor maliszewski for the rest of this match. After that early breakpoint, still has access to stuff like the Hard Rock 3. Is asking Vaxei if he has practiced the nomads. Apparently no. He has not. Oh no, bro. That map's AR6. Maybe. Yeah.
Maybe.
We'll see. We'll see if either of them have really practiced it, if it gets picked at all in this match. DT4 is, again, a bit of a toss-up. I really don't know exactly where maliszewski goes from here. I was going to say Nomad 6, but I don't know about that anymore.
I mean, in fact, they practiced it. Maliszewski just said he got 100k on it, so, you know, it doesn't take too long to practice that type of map. It's something that a player like Vaxei could definitely memorize if he really wanted to. He said, I did kinda, lol. So maybe that pick could end up just going into Vaxei's back pocket right now. Maybe gonna hold on to that one for later, but now I don't know if Maliszewski's really wanna pick it, but he's gonna go for the Nomad 1 instead. That full screen aim, orbital strike. Now this map is just aim training all the way through. This is the aim player's map. There is nothing else that's really majorly tested in this map. Some of the jumps are kick slider jumps, but I wouldn't really go to put that as any sort of handicap on these players. They're probably going to be very comfortable on this Nomad 1, but it's just who's the better raw aim player. That's all you have to think about in this pick.
Yeah, I am very interested to see how this one goes. Vaxei is known for ridiculous 10-star aim maps. Like, before there was White Cat aim clips, there was Vaxei aim clips, right? Like, when you go look at the leaderboard for Alter top diff, Vaxei is still up there, right? So the raw aim on this player is absolutely absurd. Maliszewski certainly not bad at it at all. I think a big difference, though, is the BPM here. This is such low BPM aim compared to stuff like Alter or like Rasputin or any of the other like 10-star clip farm aim maps that might end up favoring maliszewski a little bit. Again, the accuracy difference in maliszewski's favor, looking very, very solid to start things out, as Vaxei finding and maliszewski finding misses kind of all over the place in this map. Bottom left corner for maliszewski there, not working out quite as well. Both of them finding misses even during the quote-unquote slow sections, because the spacing here is still literally cross-screen.
Corner jumps are so brutal, man. Both players missing on different corners. I think maliszewski bottom left, Vaxei top right, both finding breaks all across this map. It is just so brutal. 8.4 stars. But, you know, with the way the star rating system is set up right now, maps like this that are more low BPM, not really emphasis on much tapping, just full screen aim, you could probably call this one of the most difficult maps in the pool. Both players just breaking over and over and over. No one able to really find a foothold on this. The 20k lead only really made by maliszewski's accuracy lead, but around 1.5%. But Vaxei actually starts to put some combo together, gets about 100 in his pocket, but he drops it once again. What are we watching?
That moment when 100 combo is significant, right? Like, this map is just so difficult. Really, really hard to get any combo together whatsoever. It's pretty much just act lead giving the score over to maliszewski right now, who is up at 150 combo, closing in on 200 combo. Can he break 200? Oh my god, he's done it. This is actually a huge combo for maliszewski right now. Vaxei has not broken 200 combo at all. Maliszewski still going with 260 combo to his name, 97% accuracy. He misses on the burst in bottom right. Oh my god, man.
He missed the one stream. The one stream.
You can't even script it.
That is, oh my god. Okay, but Vaxei misses too. I really don't think there's too much for Vaxei left in this map. He has to hold a combo that maybe surpasses 200 if he wants to win this, or maliszewski needs to have a massive act drop. But as I say that, maliszewski once again eclipsing 200 combo. He's going to look to take about a 50,000 score lead on this, and I really think that's going to be enough going into the end.
Maliszewski asking, who the hell put streams in the aim map? Two streams, by the way, in the aim map. But is going to win this pick. I don't think there's really any way that this goes Vaxei's way. And maliszewski, really, really solid run on this map. I don't know if this gives you confidence going into something like the Hard Rock one, which is a little bit lower spacing on average due to it being in Hard Rock, but definitely a solid point for him. And 5-2 up now against Vaxei. Even if you are running out of maps a little bit as maliszewski, I think this is a very, very good position for him to be in. Just take a couple close points every now and then and you've got the win in this matchup. You know, this is not a quote-unquote real tournament, but the stakes are very real and the prize is very real. So for both of these players, they really, I think, are going at it with pretty much everything they have. It's over $1,000 on the line for the winner of this one match. So for maliszewski to be up 5-2, looking very, very close to getting that over $1,100 prize for winning the match.
Yeah, Dio, the curse. It's still real. Vaxei has 2 points. Maliszewski has swept since Vaxei reached 2 points. But the pick is back there, and I think he might finally go for the Nomad 2. I mean, he has been the most chaotic picker so far this match, but I really feel like he should pick the Nomad 2 here. If he picks the Nomad 6, I'm going to take off my headphones and leave the room.
Oh my god. Goodbye, Miles. Have a good night.
Thanks for having me, Dio. Yep. I'm gonna walk in the rain around my block. I'll be back in like 2 minutes.
All right, enjoy. So I guess I'm solo casting for now. Miles is on the depression walk as we see Vaxei picked the Nomad 6. $78. How small is your block?
Yeah. You want to see me walk around the block? You want to see me do it again?
Wow. He's fast.
Yeah, wow. I'm fast. I'm the speed player, guys. Admission: I'm a speed player. I can play these maps.
I don't know about this map, though, if you're a speed player.
This is, if you looked at the map pool at all, this map kind of stuck out like a sore thumb as the reading focus pick in the pool. With the hidden two really being, I think, more of an aim map than a reading specific pick, you have this where it's approach rate 6 and everything is stacked and, have fun. Let's see how these players fare on it. Maliszewski already finding a lot of breaks, dropping his accuracy down, and Vaxei looks like he did practice it, and there we go.
Yeah, this one's pretty much already over, I think.
Yeah, if you didn't practice this, there is no way you are going to get a good score on this. Although both players do find drops, Vaxei finally dropping down out of 99%. Maliszewski really needs to like activate like God mode or something if he wants to take it back. Although he did improve his accuracy and he's starting to hold on to some combo. He really needs, I think, Vaxei to fall down more than anything, but Maliszewski continuing to drop is already kind of over, I think, even though there is a couple minutes left.
The accuracy for Vaxei is just too good compared to the act for maliszewski, who really is just struggling a lot with reading this map, it seems like. I mean, this is AR6 with perfect stacks all over the place and overlaps that double back on top of themselves and just really, really tricky patterns. Vaxei getting a bit of free combo during the easy section as well, boosting the ACK, boosting the score, and you know, almost triple score now for Vaxei over maliszewski. I know sometimes I might get a little bit of flack for saying things are over early on, but I feel like it's warranted for a map like this where you see such a stark difference in how well the players are playing on this map. Just really, really solid play from Vaxei. Does finally find another miss, but I don't think it matters at all, as maliszewski is still not even at 100,000 score, over two-thirds of the way into the map. Vaxei at 260k and climbing, still holding 95% accuracy as well. And this looks to be a very good pick for Vaxei. Miles, what was that about some curse? I'm not superstitious, I'm not religious, so I'm gonna need you to explain that one for me. It's not my area of expertise.
Okay, so the curse is that maliszewski tablet area reading precision 144 hertz, and then you paint a red circle on your wall, you say cookie Z 5 times, and then you have Vaxei getting 350k on an AR6 reading pick against maliszewski when he has under 100k, and the curse is broken.
Well, definitely broken. Some of the scores we had for the showcase for this were just crazy. They are put more into perspective by scores by Vaxei and maliszewski playing these maps. Some of the showcase scores we had were truly ridiculous. Very solid stuff from Vaxei on that map. 360k is not an easy feat. This map is absolutely crazy. So
six misses, by the way.
Six misses on that is really ridiculous. You can see over triple score, less than a quarter of the miscount of maliszewski, and 12% ACK up. So really, really good stuff from Vaxei. And now maliszewski looking to once again find another pick into Vaxei. Probably not the Nomad 2. You maybe go for Hard Rock 1 here. You did just win Nomad 1. If you are maliszewski, maybe the Hard Rock 1 looks a little bit attractive. Maybe the DC4 looks a bit attractive, as that map's not really speed intensive so much as it is just really, really slider heavy and reading intensive. And there's the Hard Rock 1 for maliszewski. When My Devil Rises, mapped by Kirigiri.
Yeah, maliszewski looking to take the sweep on aim here, winning the Nomad 1, winning the Hidden 1, now says, you know what, I'm going to go straight on into that Hard Rock 1 as well. A little bit higher VPM than the Nomad 1, but I think it's going to be equally, or almost equally as base. As you mentioned, this is not as base because of the higher VPM and the Hard Rock, but still going to be 7.74 stars and just an all-around really difficult aim map for both of these players. But I still think Vaxei could have a chance on this one.
Yeah, I think this is like markedly easier than the Nomad 1. This is 8.3 stars after Hard Rock, which is to say still extremely hard, but lower star rating than Ryoshi no Umi no Lindworm, lower star rating than the DT1, lower star rating than the Hidden 1. So I think very doable in comparison to a lot of the other maps in this pool. This is probably one of the easier maps in the pool overall, so I'm expecting pretty high scores out of the players in comparison to stuff like the Nomad 1 or the Nomad 6 that we just saw. That said, still very, very difficult. Pretty much cross-screen jumps or halfway cross-screen jumps at 214 BPM this time around. Much higher BPM, higher object density, and lower spacing. Vaxei is going to find a miss on one of these build-up sections. Not in the Ki time yet, so early, early miss. Hopefully won't matter too much. But for maliszewski, a very, very fortunate miss for Vaxei to find early on as we get into the first Ki time here. This is where the spacing starts to pick up, and all of these Ki times are pretty much this spacing right here until you get to the very last part of the map. Both players hit the first jump sequence. Can they hit the next one? Vaxei will miss on the build-up, actually, once again. And maliszewski, it seems, better at the aim consistency than Vaxei, someone whose aim skill cap was renowned during his time. Now maliszewski, the consistency on normal BPN maps really paying off with the Nomad 1 and Hard Rock 1 picks.
Maliszewski just looks so comfortable on this. His accuracy is all the way up at 99.85. This guy is playing this like it's 4 stars, but it is almost 8 stars. And Vaxei is finding misses on these jumps. That's how you know, despite it being arguably one of the easier maps in the pool, it is just still unreal in difficulty, and Maliszewski just is not turning back now. He is approaching the halfway point of the map, still holding on to this incredible score. Vaxei has reestablished a foothold, though, up at around 350 combo, but he really needs a meltdown from Maliszewski if he wants to take this back in the end. He does find that first drop, though, at the start of the corner section, but Vaxei misaims on a stacked screen. That is so tragic. Now, looking very dominant for Maliszewski with 120k score of lead, there is not too much left to do except run this into the end.
Even with that miss in the middle for Maliszewski, I don't think it's going to matter all that much. Too many misses for Vaxei, too much act drop. So unless we see a really, really high pop-off from Vaxei at the end here, I think this is just going the way of Maliszewski.
Yeah,
can
but...
the hold is the question. This is all relatively easy patterning, so I don't think there's going to be too much of an issue here, but does find a miss again on the slider jumps for Vaxei, and it just becomes so, so difficult to find the comeback when you can't hold that decisive combo. Neither player is going to combo through the slider jump section here, as both of them find their misses, and every time they reset like this, it favors Maliszewski.
And that lead is 130k with only a quarter left in the map, with the scores being as low as they are, with the accuracy being so far in favor of Maliszewski. There's really just nothing Vaxei can do apart from, I guess, hold on to a combo, which he clearly isn't really able to do right now in this part of the map. Up at 270k is his score. Maliszewski just looking overall more comfortable than him on this pick, and he's gonna go and ascend onto match point and potentially hand Vaxei his first 1v1 loss.
Yeah, this might just be... I mean, he's gonna be at match point after this. Vaxei has to win 4 in a row now in order to win the match. And Maliszewski, I know a lot of people were doubting whether he could actually win against Vaxei in the 1v1 like this. Here he is to prove the doubters wrong. It looked a little bit shaky after Corsair's close last weekend because Maliszewski was shown to be defeatable, but it might just be time for a new era in tournaments, as Vaxei now down match points against Maliszewski, and Ristol, Chomic Box, looking to close it out with every single map left in the pool. 3 picks remaining if we go to tiebreaker, along with that tiebreaker. So 4 chances for Maliszewski to close this one out. Very, very good combo from Maliszewski at the start of the map to make sure that that map went his way. And now, maybe going into Vaxei's next pick. Vaxei has 2 picks, Maliszewski has 1. If Vaxei can win both of his own picks, he only has to win 1 of Maliszewski's picks in order to force this tiebreaker. Let's see what these picks are from Vaxei. I have to think the Nomad 2 comes out now. We're down match point. Maliszewski has been complaining about his stream stamina. It is 220 BPM spaced streams and stream stamina for this Nomad 2. Surely he goes for it. Or might be 210. I forget exactly. It's high BPM stream stamina and spaced streams. Surely that's the play.
It is 210 BPM, but I agree with you on all accounts that Nomad 2 should definitely be something that Vaxei considers right now. I think you want to get that pick out of the way because, you know, if you don't, if you pick something a little riskier, then you might not just have the next pick. Maliszewski's on match point, still has a few maps left in the pool that he can call upon. I think for Maliszewski, probably going to look at one of the 2 remaining hard rocks with his last pick. But for Vaxei, 2 picks remaining, I just feel like it has to be that Nomad 2 DT2 in some combination.
See exactly what he goes for. If it's not the Nomad 2,
DT4?
DT4 actually is the pick. Okay. Hopefully this is a good pick, LOL, he says. I cannot be sure. I don't know who wins this. Vaxei is picking it, so I guess I'll favor Vaxei on it. But, like, I don't know who wins this. Mapped by Scub Domino, last minute, Soccer Burst Remix. This is a classic slider, pretty much slider only. There are circles, but it's a classic slider aim map from way back before slider shapes became very freeform. So lots of really structured slider shapes, very clean cut slider shapes, but very, very difficult slider tech on DT is effectively the name of the game for this map. That is 5.8 stars before double time, by the way. That is all pre-double time stats on there. Star rating goes up to 8.2 stars after DT and AR 10.53 for this map. So let's see how good these players are at aiming sliders at 260 BPM on AR 10.5.
Mm-hmm. And I guess once again, I'm here swallowing my pride. Just don't question the pick, because it's Vaxei. He might have something that we don't know, and he probably does, as his accuracy looks a lot more comfortable than maliszewski out of the start. But knowing maliszewski, he'll probably adjust to this, and his accuracy will rise later. But for now, it's looking Vaxei favored before any of the hard sections. But I think it's really going to come down to some of those key eye sections where the sliders, as Dio said, become very, very long and fast. It's an AR 10.5. DT tech at this AR is very difficult. Maliszewski going to find the first drop. Vaxei looking more comfortable in the beginning of this intense section. Accuracy for maliszewski down at 91%. Vaxei already up at a 50k lead. And Vaxei, I think as long as he holds on, it's looking good for him. And he gets through that first section. Still holding on to the FC, approaching 600 combo. How far can he go?
And yeah, you know, against a lot of other players, I feel like maliszewski wins this pick because he is very good at these types of maps with double time on. But Vaxei is just a whole different beast when it comes to double time tech. This guy is so ridiculous. Comboed the entire first hard part, missed right at the end. And now we just get actually a lot of free combo, by the way. If he had held through that entire section and not missed at the end of the first hard part, this would have all just been free combo for him and free score. As it stands, it's actually maliszewski benefiting from this with a little bit of a combo lead, did hit the ending to that first difficult part. So a little bit better for maliszewski coming out of the first section, but the score lead and the ACK lead heavily favoring Vaxei. And as we get into the next hard part as well, you have to think that the rest of this map should go Vaxei's way as well. So now I think the rest of this pool looks very, very good. You have double time 2, you have Nomad 2 still left open. You pretty much have to pick one of the hard rocks if you are maliszewski. And those are not guaranteed picks at all. Reminder, Vaxei won the perennial where Hard Rock 4 originates. Oh, hold on. Might be a little premature to talk about the rest of the pool. Maliszewski holding combo. Vaxei found a slider break during the next difficult section. Can maliszewski hold and close this out? The score lead going down so quickly now. He was not looking good at all during the first section of the map, but suddenly during the back half is looking so, so good. Finally, a slider break comes through right at the end. Once again, the player with the higher combo finds the break right at the end of a difficult section. And that is a lifesaver for Vaxei, as all of this combo in the last quarter is completely free. It almost certainly would have gone over to maliszewski if he had held and not found that slider break. And now, Miles, I think we can talk about the rest of the pool.
Okay, that was one hell of a pick. I thought maliszewski found the drop earlier, but it was a combo break, and he just had that sneaky 500 combo, and I wasn't really looking at him. But at the end of the day, Vaxei gonna pull through, gonna stay alive, get that elusive fourth point against maliszewski. But maliszewski now, his own pick, has the chance to end it. As you mentioned, I do think it's gonna have to go to one of the two hard rocks. So that HR3, HR4, both techier styled, more gimmick favored maps. Something like Angel Salad, probably, I think, less favorable for maliszewski. I think the remaining hard rock, though, that hard rock 3, I think, probably gonna be something he wants to pick. But I think maliszewski might think a little bit hard about this pick, might take up a little bit of that timer, which both of these players have both been picking extremely quickly up on. But let's see. See what he has in mind. HR3, HR4, Nomad 2, DT2, the only maps that remain in the pool. And I think it's really hard to edge any of them in favor of anyone apart from probably that Nomad 2 in favor of Vaxei. Maliszewski saying, let's play DT2! He's gonna be picking the speed! Okay.
This is a very interesting pick. Maliszewski has an FC on this map. He has a hidden double time FC on this map for probably 900-ish. I don't know the exact amount. Doesn't matter. Vaxei does not. But Vaxei has looked far better on speed throughout the entire match, has looked better on high approach rate just now as well, although not by too much. Maliszewski made that map very close, and there was a double DT ban on DT1 and DT3 from Maliszewski at the start of this match, but he's gonna go with a double time suit anyway, and I guess it's mostly because he doesn't really have confidence on anything else in the pool, which, understandable, all of the maps left up are very, very difficult. I was expecting either this or the Nomad 2 to be the last pick for Vaxei. But we're going to see it come out from Maliszewski this time. Finger control and burst speed along with really difficult aim is the name of the game in this map. Pretty much everyone knows this one already. It's Kimi no Kyoko, mapped by Akali. Let's see it. Two of the best players of all time on a map which, as of recent, has only become doable double time for a very select few players. This map used to be unapproachable with double time for a very, very long time, and now we get to see two of the best players of all time compete on it in a map pool.
Yeah, you know, back early in Vaxei's day, you might have seen this as a tiebreaker in something like a round of 32 for even open ranked tournaments. But now up here, it's DT up against Maliszewski, who looks so comfortable out of the start. He has an FC on this. It is, I believe, his top play. And up at 99.85% out of the beginning. I think a lot is really going to hinge on this first break into the chorus section. We're going to see how long either of these players can hold on. I think the first break probably going to be the most crucial. Both players continue to hold through these difficult curved streams. Neither of their staminas are letting up. Maliszewski complaining about the stamina earlier in the match does not look phased one bit by this map. And both players are going to make it through that first part. And I really do think now the first break is really going to be critical to who wins this map.
Neither of them refusing to budge at this point. Double full combo still intact. Ever so slight accuracy lead for Maliszewski out of the first Ki time. We are halfway through the map miles and neither player has dropped at all. 98, high 98 ACK for both players. 98.6 for Vaxei, 98.8 for Maliszewski. There's a missile jump from Maliszewski. He drops all the bursts afterwards as well. I think he knows Vaxei is holding on to the combo right now. It's all about Vaxei at this point. How long can he hold? Can he make it through this Ki time? If he does, this map is basically over, and curse be damned, Vaxei is still looking to remain unassailable in tournaments, finding the combo through this section, still holding through the doubles, still holding through the jumps into the curved streams, not looking to drop at all. Maliszewski finds another drop, and that is it for sure on this map. 200,000 score lead for Vaxei and no combo for Maliszewski. Vaxei is going to take us to his last pick, looking for the tiebreaker against Maliszewski in this show match.
No way he FCs this, though. At this point, that is the last thing we're looking at. Vaxei holding on with a 1780 combo into the last chorus section. Let's see if he can hold on. This would be an absolutely unreal play to get in a tournament setting. Maliszewski continues to drop. It's already over. It's a formality at this point. But can this score be set? Can Vaxei show why, once again, that he is the GOAT? Why he is widely considered the greatest tournament player of all time, even up against stark opposition from Maliszewski into the ending? Vaxei gonna be getting an FC on Kimi no Kyoko.
What is this actually deal? Wild. Warmups?
No way.
Yeah, let me ask you, Candyland and Warmups. Oh, yeah, Kimi no Kyoko double time? I remember this map. This used to be a tiebreaker back in my day. Let's play a DT and let
he
me get that
care.
FC. Let
he
me get
does
that
not
FC
care.
Too. That is absolutely nuts from Vaxei. Not the pick from maliszewski. This is Vaxei's map, despite maliszewski's place on the leaderboard. Wow, what a score, and what a way to bring us to last pick for Vaxei. This is the dominance that he displayed so many times from 2018 to 2021 during his prime when he was undefeated for years in tournaments. These are the kinds of scores that cemented him as the greatest of all time, and he continues to put them out in match as well.
853 PP, if Twitch chat is to be trusted. I believe that is the tournament PP record after he has not played a tournament match for damn 2 years. Maliszewski be damned. Vaxei is still here. Even if it's a little bit late for his time, he is still the player that we remember as one of the most dominant ever, but he still has work to be done. Still down 1 point. The pick is in his ballpark. He gets to choose between Nomad 2, Hard Rock 3, and Hard Rock 4. And please, for the love of God, pick the Nomad 2. I thought he was going to pick it, like, first in the match. Yeah. The script.
851, according to my PP counter extension. 851 PP on that map, which is still tournament PP record. Absolutely ridiculous. Come on, man. Give us the Nomad 2. Finally. There it is. That is exactly, I think, the right choice for Vaxei after a match where he has been abusing the speed and stamina against Maliszewski all match long. It is time for the coming fire. By Shadow of Intent. I'm so ready for this Nomad 2. We had a ridiculous replay on this for the showcase from a secret box. I'm looking to see Vaxei match that and bring us to a tiebreaker.
We can finally say we look smart. He finally picked the Nomad 2. 210 BPM, long streams, 8.57 stars. This is something that Vaxei should be incredibly strong on, but Maliszewski looked very, very, I guess kind of blown away in the chat. He said, I'm glad at least I got 6 points, brother. You still got a map and potentially a tiebreaker to go. And this BPM, much lower, something Maliszewski could definitely long stream for ages. But for Vaxei, I think this is just his bread and butter. He won Nomad 2s up against everyone. Players like Bubble Man used to ban Nomad 2 against Vaxei because of how strong he was on this pick. And I think this is something that just Vaxei really should be able to force the tiebreaker on. But out of the beginning, Maliszewski with the accuracy lead up above 99. We have yet to really get into the long streams, though, and I think that's really where this map is going to be determined.
One big difference, though, between this Nomad 2 and pretty much any that Vaxei used to play back in the day is BPM. Pretty much nobody got above 200 BPM before 2020, 2021. So a lot of, I think, the comfort on this sort of pick from Vaxei is going to have to come from some added stamina compared to the maps that he used to play. That said, I don't think he's going to struggle too much with the stamina on this pick. It is only 210 BPM, and he has looked extremely good on the speed all throughout this match. I think, if anything, the misses for both of these players are going to come from the flow aim in this map. Here we go into the first really difficult section. Neither player has dropped so far. This first hard part is pretty much halfway through as well. Vaxei actually drops first. It's Maliszewski to hold on, and like I said, it's not the stamina, it's the flow aim that presents the highest level of difficulty in this map, as Maliszewski now able to hold on, dropping Axe due to the stamina loss, but still holding combo. That is all that matters. The longer he holds, the bigger this lead can be, as he gets now into a cool down section. He gets to regain that stamina for the next long stream part, where he needs that stamina to hold on to the flow aim to hit the streams as God intended. And Maliszewski now might just be able to take this without a tiebreaker, Miles.
The Polish beast is holding. He finally finds the drop. Why he speak? Has chained the team. He dropped so much accuracy on that stream. Vaxei finally finding another drop. If that accuracy lead of his should start to reel in the lead soon, as long as he can equalize the combo. But right now, the combo from Maliszewski was able to accumulate a lead of 70,000 score. We're gonna see how long that manages to hold. I think the last stream section is gonna be what determines this. Maliszewski needs to hold on if he wants to avoid a tiebreaker, but it is all coming down to this ending section. Maliszewski finds another chain miss. His accuracy has just gone so far down into the dumps. Vaxei holds on, but the lead, it looks slow to go back. Vaxei finds a drop, dropping his accuracy as well. And Maliszewski, another drop. The map is very quickly starting to wind down, though, and the lead is still 60,000. Vaxei, you cannot afford to break there. He finds another drop. It's just about maybe like 40 seconds left. I don't know if there's time for Vaxei anymore.
There might not be any more time with this low of a combo. It's going to take chain misses from Maliszewski. If he finds a miss on a whole like 32-note stream, it might be doable for Vaxei, but he needs to hold, and Maliszewski needs to drop, and that is not going to happen. Vaxei is the one to drop instead, and Maliszewski now almost 100,000 score up on this Nomad 2 by the end of the match. His stamina recovered. The curse intact for Maliszewski to continue winning against many of the greatest players of all time and looking to dethrone Vaxei as the greatest tournament player of all time. A spot on the throne finally opening up.
That was so close until the very end. Vaxei, we thought this Nomad 2 was so much in his favor, but Maliszewski, the Polish beast, the almost undefeatable tournament player in the last year and a half, gonna be taking the throne from Vaxei, handing him his first L.
This is the first time that Vaxei has lost a tournament match since 2017, I believe. I don't believe he lost any in 2018. He definitely did not lose any in 2019. I think this is the first time since 2017 that he has lost a tournament match. He had an undefeated run of matches from then until the end of Yuki Aim Tournament in 2021 summer. And Maliszewski has finally done it. He has finally shown that Vaxei is beatable. After the last match Vaxei had against Emrek went to tiebreaker and Vaxei came out on top ever so slightly, it is now the Polish prodigy to stand at the top. We are going to get a tiebreaker show match between these two. Unfortunate that the match itself did not go to tiebreaker, but still ridiculously close match between these two, 7-5 for Maliszewski. And now I feel like the title of tournament GOAT can start to be worked on by other players. I don't think that this one show match gives that title to anyone, neither to Maliszewski nor to Emrek nor to anyone else, but definitely there is room for other players now to make the case, as we have finally seen Vaxei can be beaten.
Although it's a little bit past his time, still, the fact that he was able to come here and put on such a show for us, we just have to have an applause for this. It was such a very close show match, and even though Maliszewski won, Vaxei put up such a great fight. But now, yeah, as you say, we can build upon it now. Maliszewski looking to take the throne, but you know, Emrek did beat him last week. So I think we have a really healthy competition at the top now for OC tournaments, and we're going to be getting some entertaining matches now, I think, for years to come between some of these players. I don't know how long Vaxei is going to stay along for this little stint back in the OC community. I'm really glad he's back, but you know, the question always arises, how much is he going to play? Can he compete at the top? And how many tournaments is he going to sign up for, if any? But still, it's just, wow, what a match this was.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think a lot of people were hoping for this tiebreaker. It would have been very, very fitting for a match between these two players to go to this tiebreaker. Probably the most iconic tournament song ever.
For sure.
And, well, not this map, but this song. A big reason why many, many players got into OSU tournaments back in 2015. The original Illumator set was tiebreaker in OWC 2015 between the United States and China, which went to bracket reset tiebreaker. This version, you know, it's a little bit harder. It's a little bit more difficult. Just a tad. Everything in this map is way more difficult. It's 9 stars, like you said. The spacing goes crazy. The 1-6 streams in this are not stacked. They are space streams. and everything gets way, way more difficult in this map. It's all about the aim control, the finger control, and the skill cap for these players right now.
But yeah, you mentioned how iconic this song was. I think this song really opened up, I think, the infamous USA player pipeline. So many USA tourney players drew so much inspiration from that 2015 tiebreaker victory against China, and Vaxei was the gem of them. He was very much so the best player the United States has ever produced for such a long time, being the tournament GOAT, now going to be facing, I guess, it would have been much more iconic if this were being truly played between the two, but going to be facing a show match against maliszewski on this iconic song. I think it means a lot.
I think very fitting that this song is potentially the last song in tournament that we might see Vaxei play. We'll see if he actually is going to sign up for any other tournaments, but I think a very fitting end if this is the last song for him in any OSU tournaments, even for several years if he doesn't decide to stick around for any tournaments in his stint in the community, which probably not. Tournaments are such a time investment for players at the highest level, so definitely not expecting him to sign up for a lot of higher level tournaments.
Difficulty name finale as well, just to put the icing on the cake. I really do wish that Vaxei does sign up for some more tournaments, you know?
But yeah, true,
USA,
besides
OWC,
round table,
we need you.
Besides round table, guys. Besides round table, don't worry.
Oh, yeah, true.
We'll
see. Don't think about that. But OWC?
There's one
spot like, come
left.
On.
Surely
Vaxei goes to that, right? Find out on the next episode of Osu Ball Z.
We'll see if he's in the reveal. We'll see if he's in the reveal. I don't know the players. I mean, I know who's been revealed, but I don't know the players. I don't know the last one to be revealed. So hopefully it's Vaxei. I think a lot of people are really looking forward to seeing him once again in any true tournament. Hoping it happens.
Yeah, meanwhile, this TB is extremely close. Only 20,000 score in favor of maliszewski on this tiebreaker. Once again, I think due to the accuracy lead, which he has taken. I think during the second half of this match, there was really a turning point where we started to see Vaxei be a little bit more comfortable on the maps than maliszewski. Started to have some accuracy leads, but then again on this tiebreaker, it's looking very maliszewski favored in the ending, and it's going to take, I think, a big meltdown for Vaxei to take this show match.
Maliszewski is just so good at alt maps, man. I don't know. You know, a map like this is pretty much finger control, aim control, alt. And, you know, aside from the really high spacing jump patterns in the 1/3, pretty much everything. How did he hit that? How did they both hit that pattern? What was that, man? I'm sorry? They just hit like the 9-star square jump pattern. What's going on? I don't know. This is a very, very maliszewski tiebreaker. As you can probably tell by the combo he's got right now, he finally drops on some of the normal jumps, but dear God, bruh, that's a ridiculous score. Very, very high score from maliszewski. Very high combo in the back half of this map. As Vaxei's score is showing you exactly how difficult this map is. And I remember you put Vaxei in on pretty much any tiebreaker, and he was really always the best score, and I feel like a map like this, scores like this, really does kind of put the cap on things. That it's a new era, it's a new age in OSU tournaments. Vaxei has not been around a real tournament in 2 years, and the new cream of the crop is just as good, if not better, at the highest level.
Yeah, what an insane performance we saw from both of these players in this show match. That is, I believe, going to be the conclusion of it. No curveballs here. Maliszewski, once again, going to be taking this All-Stars show match by the score of 7-5 over Vaxei. And I am very happy I was able to cast this match with you, Dio.
Yeah, same here for sure. What a ridiculous match. What a ridiculous match that we saw between these two. Really, really happy to have been able to see such a ridiculous show match between these two. So close pretty much the entire way through. I think everybody kind of expected this match to be close, but I think a lot of people were looking to Vaxei to win this and prove that he still had what it takes. And he definitely still proved that he is extremely good in tournaments, but the players around right now, not just maliszewski, but Emrek and many of the other